Hey y'all, welcome back to my makes. Today I'm just going to be making a mixed media piece for the upcoming show for the art collective that I'm a part of, which is called Unibrow Art Collective. Shout out to my good friend Maddie for founding the collective. I really enjoy it and it is a great way to share and experience art during these difficult times. If you're just hearing about it now and you want to check it out, I will make sure to link the website in our description. We are a group of artists with different backgrounds and styles, and we come together to do online shows. You can see us each talk about our pieces and see our past shows, the Wounded Deer and Solstice Tarot show galleries on the site. So yeah, those are really dope. Personally, seeing others' creativity and beautiful artwork has really been uplifting and inspiring during the lockdown. Even though I kind of felt awkward filming myself talking about my art initially, watching others gave me a sense of strength and creativity. I'm so thankful to be part of this collective and am really excited to see it grow. So please check it out. But anyways, we have an upcoming show themed around environmentalism called We Are Earth, and I studied environmentalism for a little bit, and it is something I'm pretty passionate about, so I'm very excited for this show. I wanted my piece to focus on how global warming and the environmental crisis that we're currently dealing with are not only problems if you care about nature and animals, because that's something that people try to perpetuate. And the way that I think about it, it's rather a human problem. And the Earth has gone through mass extinctions and significant environmental changes. And although it may not be the way we know it, and a lot of the animals that we have now may be gone, life on the planet will continue regardless of the detrimental effect that we have on it. However, it is much more likely that the world that we love and everything that we love and want to see continue existing and also rely on for food security and basically the way that we live life as we know it, those things will disappear and the Earth will become more and more uninhabitable for the human race. I'm not saying that we'll go extinct, but life as we know it will change, and I don't think that the world would be able to support such large of a population of humans as it does now. A lot of environmental propaganda has to do with evoking sympathy for animals, such as turtles eating plastic, and although there's nothing wrong with that particularly, and it is a reality, I think that making it widely known that environmentalism is largely about preserving habitats and ecosystems that human beings need to continue our way of life and be healthy and survive would be more effective on getting everybody on board with the movement. Personally, humans is not what I really care about, but a lot of people who think that environmentalists are just tree huggers and people who just care about animals that don't matter, I think if they knew the reality or looked into the reality of the situation for the humankind and what their lives would look like if things keep going the way they are, then they would care more about the movement. But anyways, that is why I chose to draw this scene. If you can see, it is two rats living inside of a human skull with plants and stuff overgrowing the human skull. So it kind of represents and symbolizes what would happen if, like, a large part of the human race was not able to continue on, that life would continue on, you know? And rats are pretty hardy animals. I don't know if they would survive whatever happened, but it's just symbolic. And going along with that symbolism, the dandelions growing out of the top symbolize rebirth. So basically what this is saying is that in time there would be a rebirth of Earth as we know it. It's a weird rhyme. Rebirth of Earth as we know it, and life would continue on. There's also small little flowers next to the rat below, if you can tell, and they're forget-me-nots. I don't know. Would the Earth forget us? Yeah, probably. There'd probably still be plastic around, though, so maybe not. And then back to the skull, it symbolizes the passing of humankind as we know it, and that could really be the reality of our future if we don't change the way our societies function on a large and fundamental scale. There are so many things that I could get into on this, but I'm not going to, because although this video is longer than my usual videos, it is not that long. I am going to go into a couple of things that I've been noticing on social media and that have been on my mind. One of them is veganism. It is a really big trend right now, and I love that. I try to incorporate veganism and vegetarianism into my meals and my lifestyle, but I've seen it largely associated with being an animal lover on social media, and that's one of the large reasons why I do it, and I'm sure a lot of other people. But to me, the most impactful component of being vegan or trying to be vegan is the effect on the planet. Making meat requires a significantly larger supply of land and water and other resources than cultivating plant-based food. It makes up half of all the water used in the United States. Half. The other half is everything else, including residential usage, farming, business, anything that you can think of. The meat industry takes half of our water. The meat industry is also a significant consumer of energy and emits more CO2 than either business or transportation. It is a super huge contributor to global warming, especially the making of beef, because cows themselves fart so much that it has an impact on global warming, which is crazy. I try often to think about my priorities when it comes to eating meat, because as you guys know, I am a foodie and it's hard to let go of those things. So every time that I come across the option of buying plant-based food versus meat, I try to think about what's important to me. Is the humane treatment of animals and the well-being of our planet less important to me than tasting beef? And sometimes I do get meat, but I do try to cut down and limit my consumption of it. So being vegan, or just decreasing your consumption of meats and animal products in the ways that you can, not only decreases the suffering of animals, but it prolongs the amount of time that Earth will be a habitable place for humans and animals alike. Another topic that I saw controversy about on Instagram, and one that is honestly really relevant, always has been relevant, and is important, is that environmental issues are linked to racial injustices. This is an extremely deep issue, so if you want to learn more about it, even if you don't want to, you should really do some research on it. But I'm just gonna go over it briefly because I'm really not qualified to be teaching you about this. But the basis of the idea is that environmental hazards affect people unequally, placing people of color at a disproportionately higher risk to pollution of necessities such as air and water. Environmental racism leads to communities of color having higher risk and rates of diseases such as cancer, respiratory issues, and birth defects. This is affected by a number of different things, including economic strategies and political, let's say political strategies. Yeah. But it is a brutally real and really, really important injustice that is continually occurring, has been occurring, and will keep occurring until we do something about it. It really is not covered on the news very often, and I did not learn about it when I was going through middle or high school. I am really excited to have seen it on social media, which means that the general public is starting to discuss it, which is super awesome and gives me more hope. So yeah, these are just a couple of the examples off the top of my head about how the environmental movement is just as much about humans and our society as it is about nature and the extinction of animals. It's honestly not one or the other. This is all very intersectional, very connected. But yeah, if you do want to learn more about this and read more about it, I will include some links in the description below that you can read, but you can also just search these topics online and they'll come up. I highly recommend doing so. I think it's important for our entire race to be learning and aware of these issues. But on a more positive note, light is being shed on these truths. Discussion is increasing. People are starting to pay attention, and the younger generations are really, really pushing for activism surrounding environmentalism. And the fact that people are talking about environmental racial injustices right now on social media, that's super dope. Yeah, so I am becoming more hopeful, and hopefully you do too. I am excited to see what my fellow artists in the collective are thinking about this topic and to see their beautiful artwork. That show will be coming out on September 20th, We Are Earth, on our website. You can also follow the Unibrow Art Collective Instagram to stay updated on this stuff. But yeah, I'm super excited to check it out, and you should check it out too. I do really like how this piece turned out. It is pen and ink with watercolor over, if you couldn't tell. But it turned out really vibrant and bright, which is kind of what I wanted from this piece. I didn't want it to be dark and gloomy. Kind of like, if this happens, it's okay, but it'll be okay, but you should be aware that's gonna happen, because you might not be okay with it. So this is the final product. I do like the way that it turned out a lot. Here I am just peeling off the tape, the most satisfying part of the whole artistic process. Yes. Thank y'all so much for watching this video. I do hope you enjoyed it. I know it's very different from my usual kind of thing, and I probably won't be doing something like this again anytime soon. So thank y'all for listening to this very rare mini rant, and I hope that I can somehow provide you with some insight or inspiration that I didn't just put a damper on your day. I love y'all, and please tune in next Monday for another Maya Makes.